Hopefully it will show now. Yay! Yay! Alright, so that's working. Awesome, and we got past the part we were stuck at. But anyways, we're still gonna take a short break. A quick one. What do we have on the music right now? We have Super Mario RPG. Alright, so oh, that is a little loud. On my end. So I will be right back. Thanks for hanging out. Don't go anywhere. Or, you know, go use the bathroom, go get some coffee. Go do whatever you gotta do, but then come back. Then we're gonna get down to the investigation, try and find out more. I still think it's Thomas. Nothing. Maybe it's Thomas and this Diane chick. Maybe the art chick was there because she wanted this as art. Maybe her trees need to be taken to a new level of creativity, but she needed Thomas to do the dirty work. And Thomas is all, oh, you're so pretty, and you sleep with me. Yay. All that mess. Anyways, I'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. All right, I am back. Okay, game works. Okay, so, let's see. Okay. Yeah, that was actually, that was fan artwork done by... Excuse me. Wow, why can I not remember his name? You gotta be kidding me here. You really gotta be, hold on. Like an ass right now. Hold on here. No, no, not Mortac. Mortac did the steampunk. Really feel like. Then Scott. She knew it was something with his in it. Then Scott did that. That really is amazing. All right. Oh, the mystery. All right, Emily. Car. Very aware of that.
Emily, do you know a man named Forrest Kaysen?
Kaysen? Yes, I know him. The sapling salesman, right? He always uses strange comparisons when he talks.
I'd like to know more about him. What does he do when he comes to town?
He's a salesman, so I guess he sells things. Maybe he comes on vacation. We haven't seen many tourists recently, but he comes pretty often.
Is that all?
Well, now that you mention it, he seems quite friendly with the Ingrams, with Isaac and Isaiah. Maybe you should ask them about Kaysen.
Okay, I will.
They're, what, farmers and salesmen. It would kind of make sense. We can go to the diner. A few hours. Take a quick look at the map. Idea what that is. That's new. Kind of makes me want to go check it out. All these people. They're right up the road, right? Alright, so. Yeah. Go straight up the road. My booth. Here's the booth.
Emily, don't you find it a bit suffocating to be around George so much?
Well, we aren't always together. And anyway, I've gotten used to him.
Impressive. Women are very adaptable.
No, it's not like that, actually. George is hard-headed, sure, but he's also a hard-working man. That's why the townsfolk trust him so much.
The very epitome of the rural sheriff.
That's right. He isn't some hotshot FBI agent. This place isn't like the city. Everyone knows everyone else.
What about you and Anna? Were you too close?
No, not close, really. I don't seem to have much in common with teenagers nowadays. All they talk about are boys, clothes, and accessories. I don't have much interest in any of those things.
There is a gap between a teenager and being in your 20s.
Everyone's different, that's all. Me and you, too.
Zach, I'm not liking the way this conversation is heading. Let's concentrate on driving instead.
What? I don't know how the conversation was. Wait a minute. Oh, no. That was it, actually. Turn around, turn. That was very elite. However, we are in a cop car. I would love to have a motorcycle. Stop the car!
Is there something you want to check out? Well, either way, it doesn't matter. I can see you won't be rushed. I'm gonna go ahead, okay?
All right.
Okay, that would be fine.
The diner is open from 9 to 2100. Don't keep me waiting too long, okay?
Okay. It's closed. God. And close. Oh, that's annoying. I don't know if it has to get. Oh God, this is. Percent get. Excuse me, car. Oh man, this is kind of close. 8%. We're not gonna make it. We're not gonna make it. Crap. Wait, gas station. Oh, vandalism, really? Come on. Fill her up, buddy. Spit on my car? You are an ass. How much? $5 again. That's almost actually accurate. Well, shine her up. Dude, kidding me? Dude, whatever this guy spit is made out of, he needs to market that shit and sell the hell out of it. He can spit on one little area, fixes your car. Funny. A bribe out of him. God. Wow. Just wow.
Jack, here's the Ben Franklin you wanted.
Give it to me.
List. Thing? Or are these side missions?
Hey there, Benjamin. I wanted to talk to you. Have you heard this yet? I'll tell you another one when I see you again.
Wait, what was that? What did he say?
Zach, did you see that? It was as if we weren't here. I wonder what that was all about. Did it make sense to you?
Oh, sir. Wait a minute here. Hold on. No.
Zach, is there something here that you want to check out? We are supposed to meet Emily at the diner, but
yeah,
that's
we
fine.
Will. We will. Calm down, York. We'll get it. Oh, a trading card. I don't even know what he said. That's the tip? I gave him $100 to listen to that? Oh dog. Okay. Oh my god. And yes, guys, welcome back. We did fix it. Oh my god, I am so mad. I am so freaking mad. One of the movies. Well, at least we let him spit on our car, right? That's a plus. Magic Jack's gay. Oh God, what the man? What's up with this?
Zach, don't you think there are a lot of good looking women in this town? It's like heaven compared to the town we grew up in. Do you remember Liz? Prom queen, Elizabeth Scott Moore. She could be royalty with a name like that. But you know, she was like an actress from a B-movie, wasn't she? Bleached blonde hair, too much makeup, clothes showed off her cleavage, and that mole by her mouth.
That mole!
Were you with me back then? You know, that mole was made with makeup, right? We happened to be on the same bus once. I saw her drawing it on with makeup.
Oh, cheater.
I wasn't surprised, I guess.
Cheater mole.
Just impressed that she would go that far to create that image. Do you remember that movie we went to go see that day? I'll give you a hint. It was the fourth in a popular series and was produced by Menachem Golan's Canon Films. Figured it out, Zach? Think it over then. Call it your homework until next time.
Oh my god. Whatever. Let's park it. Lord, is that?
Emily, were you waiting outside for me?
Should I have gone inside and started the 20 questions?
Well, that would have been fine with me. Shall we get something to eat, then?
Someone should teach you how to be more considerate. And now you want something to eat? I thought we were going to question Nick.
The diner, we can do both, really. Why are you out of focus?
Welcome, Mr. Agent.
Hi, Olivia. Let me have your special for today. And some fresh coffee.
Our special today is turkey. A turkey and gravy sandwich. Sound good?
Delicious.
Oh, perfect. Emily, you eat something too. It'll be on the FBI.
Okay, then. I'll go all out. I'll have the T-bone steak.
Damn!
Because it's a little too expensive.
A fucking turkey sandwich and she gets a T-bone? Oh, look who it is.
Mrs. Olivia Cormack, I am here for Mr. Stewart's lunch. If it is ready, I'd thank you a bunch.
Yes, fucking of course. Just a moment.
Oh, the run.
Here you go. The usual. One turkey, strawberry jam, and cereal sandwich.
Sounds like the sinner's sandwich. Self-inflicted punishment to atone for past sins. He's setting an example.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, you should try this wonderful lunch. It's more than a delicious, tasty crunch. So says Mr. Stewart.
No, that's fine. I've just ordered my own lunch.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, Mr. Stewart's order is delicious, I should mention. And Mr. Nick Cormack is a genius for creating this perfection. So says Mr. Stewart.
Still, I have a hunch I might not like it. You sure that sandwich is that good?
Mr. Francis York Morgan, making decisions based on intuitions is always a sign of bad FBI agents. So says Mr. Stewart.
Harry, you're right. I'll give it a try. I can't believe it. This is fantastic. It's really good. Olivia, I'm sorry, but can I change my order? I'll have what Harry is having.
Their faces.
Nick and Diane. They hardly make the perfect couple, do they? Is it widely known that they go drinking together, just the two of them?
To be honest, I don't pay attention to these things.
Not into local gossip?
Well, when I moved here, I was still in high school, and I kept wearing the same wild clothes from my school in Seattle. I was young back then. And before
fucking
I
delicious.
Knew it, there were rumors all over the school. She'll screw anyone. That's what they said. Totally unfounded, of course. Anyway, after that, I just sort of chose not to really trust gossip.
I get where you're coming from. I used to dress like a hardcore punk rocker when I was in high school.
You? A punk rocker?
Nobody took my side. Even when I had good grades, people rejected me just because of what I wore. I was young back then, too.
Even still, I just don't see you as a punk rocker.
And you laugh? Look at you. No makeup on, dressed in uniform, eating a steak for lunch. Okay, back to work. Let's talk to Nick.
You know what? Hang on. Just a moment. Just a moment. Okay, so we're back. All right, so what we have here is a lovely turkey. I didn't have strawberry. I have grape. Jelly. Not jam, jelly, whatever. And some cereal. And if my prediction is right, I should get psychic powers. I should get psychic powers. Okay. Yeah, I don't really know what else was on it though. I just know it was turkey. I don't have like lettuce or mayo or anything like that. So, This is going to be delicious. This is going to be absolutely delicious. What is this link? Oh my God. Okay. Espanto, go upload that onto the Steam site right now. Oh my God, you gotta do that. You have to do that. You have to do that. Okay. That's going on up with the rest of the artwork. That is great. Okay, so once again, we have the turkey, grape, not strawberry, with cereal. We're gonna try this again. Definitely. They didn't really say what's. This is actually just Special K. That's all this is. So. Cheers. Not bad, actually. Not bad. You know, it's Not bad. Surprisingly, I thought it was going to taste terrible, but not bad. Huh. Ooh, it's on to something. Bad. We've taken something from this game. Tangible. That's not bad. That's really not that bad. I'm quite surprised. Huh. Dinner sandwich for the win. Dude, yeah. I guess I'm trying to atone for passing. Bad, though. Bad. Right. Oh, what I'm having for. She can have her free. Oh, Kaysen. Dude, that. Oh, where is. I gotta take a look at this picture again. That is phenomenal. Like, what the hell is he looking at out the window and everyone else is just fucking chilling? Meanwhile, I apparently see fucking Bigfoot coming out of the forest. That picture is gold, man. Picture is gold. Gold. Alright. We'll talk
you.
To you. Oh. Overalls. Okay. Wait, what are you eating? The huffing and puffing. The moment you. No one else sees it coming but me. Oh, that's fantastic. Okay, we want to talk to Nick. Nicky. Coming in your kitchen.
Hey, I'm working here. You can't just stroll into a chef's kitchen.
Then perhaps you would give me your permission to enter.
No. Get the hell out of here.
I'm Nick.
Zach, everyone has their own sanctuary. Let's leave him in his.
Say that, did I? Never said that. Why would you suggest that to me when I... They're having air, that's what it... I'm working here. Interesting, interesting. Olivia, spill the beans. What's going on with you in the art gallery?
There's something I'd like to confirm with you, Olivia, if that's okay.
Yes, well, so long as it doesn't take too long.
First, what were you and Nick doing on the night of the murder?
I was here in the diner. Nick said he was going to the bar for a couple of drinks.
Does he go to the bar often? Leaving you to hold up the fort?
Yes. He says he enjoys the conversation with Diane. I thought they went drinking again together that night.
Do the three of you ever go drinking together?
Well, you see, I'm really not into art.
And your husband is well versed in the arts then, I take it?
Oh, yes. Looking at art and talking about it is his way of relaxing.
People just aren't what they seem.
Bullshit!
Like a certain someone who was into punk rock 10 years ago.
Really? You're gonna drag that?
Absolutely right, Emily. But you can be an art lover and a liar at the same time. One more thing, Olivia. You just said that you aren't interested in art.
That's right.
You were at the gallery!
So, how come I bumped into you at the art gallery? Didn't seem like Nick brought you there. You were there alone.
I like trees, is the thing. That's why I went there.
About so.
Surely you'd be better off in the forest rather than an art gallery, then.
Dude, give her the third
degree. I
think
you went to the gallery not to see trees, but to see Diane, right?
Uh-oh.
You don't want to answer? Or perhaps this isn't the right place to ask.
Meet me in the backyard. You can get there from the parking lot. I'll wait for you there for an hour after we close up.
They're having an affair. That's what it is.
They close at 2100. Should we get something to drink and wait?
Go to the bar. Get Stinko.
Agent York,
picture.
What do we do now?
I want to hear what Olivia has to say. Let's kill time until the diner closes.
Okay, then I'm going to make a trip back to the department. I'll see you in the backyard later.
Okay, sounds good.
See you later, then.
Zach, about Olivia. I presume she wants to tell us something about Nick and Diane. Let's hope it's not just something for the gossip columns.
All right, I have some time to kill. Where can we go? Under your shit, buddy. What is the Harold? Oh. Oh, who's this? Oh, damn noise gate, I swear to God. The noise gate is going to be... Thank you. Great. Bridge coming up here. Oh my! Really annoying how it just spins out like... Dude, don't fucking honk at me, boy. Right? I'm in a cop car, I'll pull your ass over. No problem with it. Could we take this... down. Car all over the road. Yeah, too much background noise. Too much. I mean, I have an AC going and the other computer is too loud. So I gotta keep it going. Why is... Oh, the junkyard, that's weird. You'll just hear it running in the background all the time. Thank you. All this junk. Oh, it's a general. Rushing on the battlefield will get you killed. Good thing this is not a battlefield at all. Treasures. More carefully.
Hmm?
On a car. Then you shopping? What am I looking for? My cars? Oh, you gotta be kidding me here. Fuck! You're kidding me, I can buy cars? Really? Give it to me. Oh. Good shopping. They can't give me a ticket. I'm the freaking FBI. They're trying to give me a ticket. I'll shoot them. Right in the face. Excuse me, Pike. Card. Ah. Thin-skinned, how are you doing? I am counting new followers on my head every single cast. There's a new follower. Excuse me. It happened. Come on, bust it up. There we go. And I get a medal. Game is all. Grand Theft Auto 5 can suck it. Oh, York's car is really kind of sexy. I should have bought that. I still can buy that, actually. I have a couple of grand. I don't see myself tossing a couple more Benjamin. X what? What you want again? Let's talk. App.
Now then, young fella. How do you feel about your current vehicle?
My vehicle? It's a piece of crap, but I'm not here to talk about that.
Then how about a little treasure hunt? Listen up, young man. My junkyard is actually a mountain of treasure. All kinds of treasure lies in those mountains of junk. The problem is, there's so many, I've lost track of where everything is. You've caught on already. I can see it in your eyes. I need you to head out in the yard and find certain things for me. If you help me out, I'll customize your car a little.
What are you talking about?
Didn't I tell you to shut up and listen to your superiors?
Damn, motherfucker, I'm FBI.
I don't see any reason to refuse.
To murder you.
First, I'll need some low gear parts. With that, I'll be able to boost the engine of your car. You'll find one around E5. Go. Oh. Don't just stand there. Get going.
Look, I will turn your ass. Freaking Lieutenant Dan. If you ever talk to Mr. Francis York Morgan like that again, I swear to God, I will burn your junkyard to the ground. All right, now then, E5, he said. Correct. Seriously, he's just gonna yell at me like that? Terrible. Alright, E5. There's E. That way. Hold on. Before I do all this for. How can I pick which car? Edit. R. Oh, it's so sexy. Look at it. Oh, man. However, the other car. What's the other car? Can't remember. I need to look at my trading card. York's car. It looks like a must. Looks like it. I think we'll keep the Corvette. Can I own mold? York's car even for sale. That's a good. It is not. Port wagon. Oh boy. Power low. Fast. Playing difficult. Whatever. We'll stick with the Corvette. E5. Oh my God. So far. Oh God. Please do them with us, whatever. And FBI, we cross hurdles every day. Boxes. Oh, there it is. Low gear parts. Give it to me. I mean, I'm just... No, they said don't read the trading card. I believe that's what they said. You can collect them, but don't read them. Unless I find one, it's like, the killer is... so-and-so. All right, buddy, I got your parts. Snap at me again, I swear to God, it's gonna be... Yeah, I found...
This is it. This will save your life someday, son.
You sure know how to exaggerate?
As I put it away. This will save your life, and you'll never have it.
Alive from war.
Engine boost.
Of course. Engine boost is the basis of everything. Let me tell you a war story, son.
This voice kind of changed up there,
didn't
it? I was
leading my unit at the very front line. Things were bad, and sanitary conditions were worse. Endless guerrilla attacks were stripping us of our manpower. Everyone was tired to their limits. There was one sergeant who really rubbed me the wrong way. The boys liked to call him Crybaby Timothy. He really gave me headaches, I can tell you.
How?
Just by breathing.
Caleb, how you doing?
His posture
was bad.
Good to see you again. He was weak, slow, easily distracted. I have no idea who thought he was capable of combat in a war zone. He endangered the lives of every member of the unit. Stomach pains. The worst stomach ache ever. Every one of us. It was just cooking. He was using food that was contaminated. I flew into the dugout toilet like an Apache chopper returning to base. I have to tell you, it was a close call. My engine was boosting. And that's what got me there safely, right in the nick of time.
What happened to the
unit?
You really want to know? It was a terrible sight. Powerful, athletic men reduced to walking dead. Blinking like crazy, shaking with pain. Their confidence and self-esteem were all crushed. They almost didn't recover.
An interesting story.
So you see the need for engine boost now, do you? I'll keep my side of the promise and get to work on your vehicle.
Wow. That's a war
that
story,
all right. For a sergeant. Looks like it was sewn on something else before it was sewn onto his shirt. I wonder what that's all about.
I put in longer pistons and optimized your lower gears. That should add boost to your speed when you accelerate. But there's still plenty of stuff I can do to make your car go faster. Just come see me again and I'll customize your car a little more.
This guy is best fucking... He did that in like minutes. We were still just standing here. No. I didn't want to do it. Fuck. He's not gonna... Whatever, old man. Oh, man. Get in the car. No backseat either. I think George is going to be doing some walking. Oh, that hood! It's not really peeling out there. I need to break it. Break. Then gun it! I think we're peeling out. We don't have food. Oh my god, this is great. What was that? Oh, talk.
To recap, the movie was the fourth sequel in a series that started in 1978. That's right, Zach. It was Superman 4, The Quest for Peace. Lex Luthor was back. It was played by Gene Hackman.
That alone made it a must for all us fans.
I don't know where I'm going. More about it, though. Just driving.
I'm sure there was more trivia about it. Still, forget four. Richard Donner directed one and two.
Stop.
Now those two were great movies. Christopher Reeve really shined as Superman. Actually, Zach, I've got a confession to make. Promise not to tell anyone because I'd be really embarrassed. I actually like the first two Superman movies more than the first two Star Wars movies. I think John Williams did a better job with the theme song for Superman. But whenever I try to hum it, it always turns into the Star Wars song somewhere along the way. I know it's strange, Zach. I know.
Hank.
So, Zach, which Richard Donner film do you like the best?
No need to worry. Take some time and think it over.
Fill her up, but don't you fucking spit on it. Don't you do it. Don't you do it. Fill her up. Don't do it. Oh, you sack of shit. I will murder you. I will murder you. I just got this. I will kill you. You understand that? I will take your little bandana off your head with your whatever wannabe solid snake, way too overgrown style thing that you're trying to rock, and wrap it around your neck and suffocate you until you die. How dare you fucking spit on my car? You asshole. I'm fucking Francis York Morgan, and I will kill you. Sorry. Protective of sexy. As well, apparently this guy also spits gasoline. Good to know. Oh God, no! What time is it here? It is 11:02. I'll stay right here in the middle of the street. Who's this? Let's talk to them. Bung Ho, what's going on, buddy? Good to see you again.
I went to see every Richard Donner movie on the day they premiered. Every single one.
Every single
Goonies. Lost Boys.
Goonies!
Oh. The Weapon series. But my favorite has to be Lady Hawk. That was back in 1985. Same year as Goonies. Both Rutger Hauer and Michelle Pfeiffer really shine in that one. But more than anything, it's the story setting that was really good. A love story about a cursed knight that changes into a wolf at night. And a cursed maiden that changes into a hawk during the day.
Come on, let's race.
Don't you think so?
Race. Come on.
They can only be together.
Come on, pull up.
Right between day and night.
Whoops.
Together as humans for only a brief moment.
Come on.
Perfect setting for a fantasy movie.
Let's race. Vet versus vet. Come on.
I really like those movies that have women changing into animals.
Come on.
Can you tell which movie I just
remembered? Come on.
That's right, Zach. With Nastasia.
Come on, Richard and Sally. Oh, that's right. He's just checking me out. Hey, your babe's checking me out.
We'll finish this later.
Oh, God. All right. Hold on. Motherfucker, don't. Where are you going? Stop moving so much. All right. You ready? Count of three. One. Two. Peace, bitch. Oh, you're slow ass. All right. Where are we? I'm not even using boost, and I'm kicking your ass. Oh, shit. Still kicking your ass. Mountains can't stop me. Oh, God. Alright. We're going back to town. Oh, God. Oh, Jesus. The handling's a little loose on this. Oh my god, we're sliding. I don't know if we're sliding or what. Oh, fence. Fence. It looked like she had a mustache, dude. Oh god, curb. I'm in a van. Oh, wait a minute! Foot on the brakes! Oh, that's the e-brake or what? Let's try race. Try. Come on. Who hit me? Who hit me? Who hit me? Who hit my baby? You. You. I've done that. Should not. The hell? How long did it take me to get out the car? The fuck, man. Whatever. Been here. Not quite. That's where we're going when the time is. Oh, we have so much time to kill. Let's try and do an actual little bit of FBI. Shall we? That is George. Jeez. Oh, that's Richard. Wait a minute, where are they going? This. Oh. Panda Bear. That's two bars. Romy. Oh, that's the pot lady. Right, let's go check out the pot lady. Where am I right? Straight down here. Y'all. Turn on that Pansy Drive. Pansy Street. Going to Pansy Street. Where am I going? Shit. Facing north or south? Wrong way.
We have Nastassia Kinski in the lead role and Paul Schrader directing back in 1981. That's right, Zach. Cat people.
Cat people.
About a woman who turns into a leopard when she falls in love and then eats the person she loves.
I thought it was romantic. Real romance right there, Zach.
Nastassia was perfect for that role.
Perfect.
Casting her made that movie a success.
Get out of the car. Like this.
Zach, we'll finish our chat later. Let's take a walk around here.
That is a federal offense! Bullets in the mailbox. What the... That's not right. And now we're going to snoop and look people. I saw that movie. Did you really? Is it any good? Bad people. Oh my god. Nothing's happening here. I was like seven. Well, damn. You saw a movie like that when you were 7? Chick who makes people fall in love and she eats them? Or something along that line? I would really like a boot. George! George! Okay. The right way, right? Are you more cool? What do you happen to somehow remember what the name or what the rating was? Be right around. Where are you wandering, Sigourney? Right. Where are you? There she is. Sigourney. None of you knew that the Corvette had such off-road capability. Sigourney! Stop, I want to ask you a- oh, sorry. Where are you? Come here, old lady, with your pot.
Hey, Sigourney.
I'm glad you're here. My pot. It's getting cold. Please,
who's missing?
Let's get going.
Could you explain what you're talking about?
What are you rambling on about? My pot's getting cold as we speak. Hurry! Hurry!
Zach, I guess we're going to have to drive her home. But I wonder what happens when her pot gets cold.
Drive her home? Driving safely may not cut it this time. Oh. I guess we're actually going to drive.
Now, get the car going.
All right.
My house is over by the lake.
You got it.
3, 2, 1, go.
All right. Let's do it.
This is not good. It's losing more and more of its warmth. At this rate, my pot is going to get cold.
Hello?
Hurry!
I put the heater
step
on.
It
stepped.
Why do you have to drive so safely?
Oh my god.
You see, my pot is getting cold.
Oh my god.
It is not good.
Here.
It's losing more and more of its warmth. At this
take that.
My pot
warm up
is
your
going
pot.
To get cold.
Oh my god.
Hurry. Hurry.
Is it warm?
Step on it. Why do you
keep
have
the fire
to drive
by it
so safely? Can't you see my pot is getting cold?
Hold it over the fire, bitch! Come on! Oh god.
This is not good. It's losing more.
Oh my god. Fine, don't use the fire.
My pot is going to get cold.
Whatever, it's fine.
Hurry! Step on it! Why do you have to drive?
Espen, you take it easy.
Can't you see my pot?
We'll see you later.
Why?
Oh my god, shut up, you freaking nagging lady. Where's your house? Right. That's. Hold on. Where am I going? Where's your house? Is this your house? I don't know. Oh, wait a minute. Have I been going the wrong way? Mother! Cool, we got it. Got this. Break! Bring it. Bring it around. Bring it around. Go, go, go. Go.
This is not good. It's losing more and more.
Shut up.
At this rate, my pot is
I'm going to kick you out of this car. I swear to God.
Hurry. Step on it. Why do you have to drive so safely? Can't you see my pot is getting cold?
You don't even have your pot. Oh, my. Oh, God. Where's your pot? Nice car. Look at the interior. Oh, you scratched it, you fucker. Look at it, though. Got the very nice panel board right there. Bet that's touchscreen.
This is not good. It's losing Wait a minute. Did more I and more miss?
Nope, right here.
At this rate, my pot is going to get cold.
Why do you walk so far from your house with a...
Why do you have to drive so...
Move!
Can't you see my pot is getting cold?
We're in a hurry. We got a room temperature pot right now.
This is not good. It's losing more and more of its warmth.
Where's the house?
My pot is going to get cold. Hurry. Hurry. Step on it.
There it is.
Why do you have to drive so safely?
Oh!
Getting cold. This is
Shut not up!
It's losing more at this rate.
Get out of my car! You annoying bitch! Get out!
Oh, thanks to you, my pot is still warm.
I'm glad to hear that.
Don't get so excited, will you? Keep your voice down.
What, are you going to tell me a secret?
The pot knows everything.
You've been smoking a little too much of it.
If you can't find the person you are looking for, you need to look at things from a different angle. There is only one truth, but more than one is always visible. Like cooking a stew. Mix things in and wait for it to boil together. Just make sure it doesn't get burnt. And keep an eye on it. You have to gently mix it sometimes and wait until it's ready. Listen carefully. The best stew is a stew that is boiled slowly. Oh my! My pot is getting cold again! Did you have to talk so long? Oh!
For the good of the community, we're gonna just make the report that there were bugs. Child. Do a invasion right now. And take a bullet. Oh, she lost a shoe. Come out and get the shoe sometime. My car smells like pot. What's going on, Tasty? How you doing, buddy? That was, Lords of the Fallen. This is the one you're thinking of, Tasty.
Zach, picking up from where we left off,
we have Nastasia Kinski in the lead role and Paul Schrader directing back in 1981.
That's right, Zach. Cat people.
about a woman who turns into a leopard when she falls in love, and then eats the person she loves.
I thought it was romantic. Real romance right there, Zach.
Nastasio's perfect for that role. Casting her made that movie a success. Malcolm McDowell as her brother was also a good call. He's like a panther even without any of that special Hollywood makeup.
Now the name Malcolm McDowell rings another bell. You know the movie I'm talking about, right, Zach?
No.
Don't tell me you're thinking about Clockwork Orange. Malcolm McDowell, come on, it's pretty obvious. Blue Thunder. Came out in 1983, was directed by John Badham. Malcolm plays the bad guy in that one.
I haven't seen that.
He totally outshines the hero, Roy Scheider. At least I think so. I have to say, not many people agree with me about Blue Thunder.
Zach, if you disagree with any of my opinions about movies, just come out and speak your mind, okay? Just speak your mind.
Okay. Oh well. Where am I going? Around. Yeah, you know, Huge Gemini Live brought up a good point with that whole pause feature. When I do cast that game, a rule will be not use that pause feature whenever I am fight. Maybe if I'm like standing somewhere in a village or something where I am perfectly safe, I just want to pause the game, I'll do that. Otherwise, I don't want to be in a fight, be able to pause and look around and see what's coming. If something's going to be coming my way, just let it come. Why is this pink? Gotta be a reason that's pink. Where am I? That. Why is roaming now at the hotel? How far up the road am I? Lord, I'm pretty far up. Yeah, I know. I like to make things more... Well, I mean, you couldn't do it in Dark Souls. And, you know, Dark Souls was just great. So, for me, personally, I figured keep up the same kind of challenge. You know me. 9 times out of 10, I'm always going to try and make the game more difficult. Hotel should be... Oh. Right here. Yeah, whiplash. Holy fuck. Turning on this thing's not bad. Whoop. Wow. Get out of the car. Get out of the car. There's a metal. Can I beat these bushes? Beat the bushes. Crap. How can I get that? Oh. All right, maybe we'll stop by my room. Delicious coffee. We'll Clash of Titans. I did the exact same thing, Tacy. Not too long ago, I watched the live-action Super Mario movie. And my God, some things are just better to stay. That shit. I mean, it's still great just because it's Super Mario live action. You really notice all the horrible acting, the terrible line. So many cornball lines. Can I change suit? Let's put on our new suit, shall we? With that new, oh my God. What is that suit? That, I believe that flies, don't go on there. Cleaning. Oh! We're doing it. It looks like rain. Does not look like rain. God. Come on down to Bargain Dan's warehouse of savings and magic. I'll find you a deal or I'll eat my hat. Yeah, sure. Yeah, sure. Ooh-wee. Where's my hat? A little bit of coffee. Need to cut back on my spending.
Gold. I once caught a criminal who had gold front teeth. His mouth lit up like a neon sign when he laughed. What did they call him? Oh, right. They called him the Medalist.
Indeed, I am silly. That is interesting.
A cell phone.
I have one.
I lost my lucky item on the way into town then. This is a most ironic fortune.
Crap. I don't have a cell phone. Never mind. That ain't happening. All right. Big hotel. This. Oh, this for coffee. Take it. Said what? 24 hours to do the laundry? Is that what it said? I don't want to do the laundry, Prince. Laundry. Walking everywhere like this? No way in hell. No way in hell. Where's my car? Alright, we're definitely gonna have to, go back to the junkyard at some point in the near future so we can get some more upgrades as well, just buy more, collect the whole set. Crap. Maybe I want to be stinky. They're one of the flies swarming
Zach,
around.
If you notice anything, just stop me.
Where are we going? I don't. That's the diner. George's house. You haven't checked out George's house yet. It's the junkyard. Who's that? Is that who I think it is? Dang it, Sigourney! Stop wandering! Where am I? Yep. Not taking her home. I've been wandering. Turn. Oh god, too much. Much too much. Your lord going downhill. Oh! Not so great when you try and turn. Tell ya. Is that GPS lifetime? It is? Oh, no way. That's awesome. I can just sit here and look where I'm going. And see it on the GPS. And see you either, asshole. Get yourself on the GPS. Okay, here we go. Saw him. Be turning like right here. Nope. A little too early. Damn it. Oh, it's because I'm not looking at the GPS. Coming right up on the. Oh, shit. Damn it! GPS needs to be up. Wait, George's house. God, that slide though. Terrible. Oops. Damn it, wait. Wait a minute. Where am I? Who's this? This is not at all where I was going. Where was I going? Thought I was just going up and over, right? Yeah. Okay. And then George's house could be here. Right? Yeah, because we came up here, cut over, came down. Come down too early? Is that where George's house was? Where is George now? George! Where did George go? George apparently became abducted. Galaxy of Terror. Isn't that a bar? What kind of name is that for a bar? Go check it out. Excuse me, asshole. Turn here. Odd. Small town, rude people. Where's his house that way? Galaxy of Terror. It's closed. However, there's something up there. Engine. Let them know we're here. Are we? Oh, it's a trade. Ah, whatever. Oh God, a dog. Where? Galaxy of Terror. What the hell kind of name is that for? Bar. An arcade. Alright, I know George's house was somewhere around. Excuse me.
Zach, if you notice anything, just stop me.
Wait. Like almost a 360. That was amazing. It does grow on you, man. It grows on you. What is this? Excuse me. What the hell was Tom or not George's house? Or just get up and move suddenly? What? And the lines. Bank. No, I haven't really been to the bank. And, I would like more money. I have a gun. Bank. I kind of see connection. Dude, move, asshole! I had to right away. My car's better looking. Leave it right here. Bank, right? Ash Mark. CDOGV. And the bank. All right, let's do this. Let's make it quick and nasty. At what time? Did it say? Why not? It's a bank. What's wrong with that? Okay, let's see. Bar, same old. Good Day Bakery. You Mash Bros. Oh, vending machine. Everything's gonna cost an arm. My God. $35 for a cracker. What? Found. You know, I can't help but think that some of these buildings have been... are on the outskirts of town. Okay. What we need to do, we need to just find pillow around. Actually, we might need to get some gas, which means this bastard's gonna spit on the cart. If I'm right, the gas should be straight up the other way. Yep, there it is. You turn it here. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Damn it. Turning on this thing sucks when you're going slow. Right? Oh, it's like a. Oh, wait. There it is. See how long before that gets done.
Zach, we can take a rest if you're tired.
Yeah, after we get... gas. We'll take a little nap here. Get through... Too early. Damn it. All right, fill her up in spit shiner. Oh, hi. He does.
Uh-huh.
Hey. Doing Daisy Duke. We're up. What are you doing? Why was that so funny? Yeah, pump it. Pump it all night. All day and all night, girl. Yes. Yes, I'm sure. Didn't even do anything. Wipers. All you did was breathe on my windshield and wipe it with a giant sponge. And the car is restored to new. I'm telling you, these people, man, have magical powers. I love it. I absolutely love it. Turn the wipers off. Turn the blinker off. Know where there's a little sleep shack. Right, Joshy? How you doing, by the way? Good to see ya. Welcome to the cast. Oh, God damn it, Tasty. You made me take my eyes off the road. Get, oh god, what, stop! Which way is it? It is, no, that's the, I'm still on the right track. So we have two options right now. We can get some sleep, or, well, hold on. Where's the junkyard again? That's right, because the junkyard is right next to George's house. So find George's house, you find the junkyard, you find George's house. Where is it? Wait, was George in this town? Up over here? Is that the junkyard? Electrical substate. There's the junkyard. There's George's house. I was way off. I was in the wrong neck of the woods. Yeah. Turn it in. Move. Move. FBI coming through. Ah, good old Z lady. I haven't seen her around in the past couple. Maybe I've just missed her cast time. Oh god. Oh god. Oh lord. Once you kind of lose traction. Car. Oh god! That's why they say don't text and drive. Do it. Excuse me. I think it's this way. It's okay, we're FBI. We can do this. Oh. She really is, isn't she? Oh, look at that park. Good stuff. Get out the car! Alright, buddy. I'm just kidding, we're FBI. Hey, General! How you doing? Talk to you. Rank makes a man. Man also makes a rank. Okay. Give me car parts. I need to buy something. I could buy a new car. What is this? Flare. Okay, I have two of those. So we have our fast and fun vehicle. A little shiny knee. That's right, I'm rocking some shorts today. Love the knee. That is naked knee. Don't see that too often. Let's crap. Volkswagen, crap. Condor S33. Let's go. Grit. Son, are you kidding? I just bought two cars from you, and you ask me if I'm kidding when I say I'm done shopping. Oh God, is it really doing it again with the noise gate? I really got to get this crap figured out. More so. Come on, man. You're not going to give. What did we just buy? We just bought. Huh. Look at that trunk. Look at that trunk. Holy shit. I'm trying to think of what you could hide in that. Like, all of fucking Europe I could fit in that trunk. I don't know. That's crazy. Listen to this music, though.
Zach, we can take a rest if you're tired.
Day 5. This case hasn't been turning out so well. Me and Zach are on our way to find some shut-eye. Who could have killed this beautiful young lady? It's hard to believe. The monsters exist in this world, so cruel, so heartless, take such beauty. This is why we do what we do, Zach. Terrible life. Oh God! We drive off a cliff. Okay. Let's go find some shut-eye. I guess we can head back to, L. You can drive the car. I guess you can drive it, but... Oh, wait, no. Now we're on this side of the car, so this is what? England? We need to go over here? Right? Isn't that how it's done? Dun 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 dun. Okay, enough of that.
Zach, we can take a rest if you're tired.
We will, very shortly. Okay, well, the blinkers and the windshield wipers worked, but they didn't sell us a jalopy. That's cool. I'm down for that. Oh my God! We recovered, it's cool. Where did I pass the hotel? No, we're right here. Sharp turning. And again, we're only going 30 freaking 5 miles an hour. Good enough, right? That's a good parking spot. Access to all my cars wherever I go. Do I really? Really? Amazing. Love it. like a portable garage pocket. All in all, it's okay. I would have preferred that if they were going to do flames, maybe black, you know, just to kind of keep color theme going, not this green. Oh, we get to talk to Polly. Dirty old Polly. Hi. Where's Polly? See what the weather forecast is. Perfect day to go for a walk. Oh, God. Did we just get FBI points for checking the weather? That's odd. Where's Polly? Where's that dirty old bird? Where's that dirty old bird? Polly. We have now turned this into The Shining. All work and no play make Yorka. Polly. Ollie, Ollie, oxen free. Left. None of this horseplay shit. Let's go take our nap. Oh. Very nice. Hold on. You have a set? Oh, it's stuck. No? Just slowly moving in the breeze. The pool? God help us if we can go. This. Oh, it's a card. Neat. So glad we found that. Okay. My God, what is this? So many doors. Oh my God, wait a minute. Picture of a beautiful lady. But that's Polly.
Now that's a pretty girl. I wonder who she is. Polly's daughter, perhaps? Maybe a granddaughter. Might be worth asking her.
Interesting. Interesting. This is Polly's room, I'm guessing. Polly's got a huge bed. A huge bed! Polly, you don't need that much bed. Our rehearsal. Free sucker. FBI. Dun 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 dun. Pow. Damn it. Fire. Fire. Bulletproof mirror. Something you get. Oh my God. All right, you know what?